Hi, my name is Kari Kublin, and I'm the product architect for FieldSync Health at FieldSync. What I'd like to go over with you today is how to do data entry on the mobile application. Now, data entry is focused around tasks or programs that are directly assigned to your customer, whether that customer be a client, a patient, a participant. So all of the things that you're doing to interact with that customer would fall underneath the data entry area. So I've logged into my mobile application as a mobile user, and just to kind of give you an idea, when I go into my patient information here, you can see that I have access to 4 patients. So these individuals have been assigned to me within the web application as individuals that I provide services to. So now when I come back to home and I go into my data entry, what I'm going to see by default are any of the programs for any of those 4 individuals that I need to document on or complete with them during the day today. So it will always default to today's date, which you can see up here. And you can see that there are some programs that have a scheduled time, and those are indicated here. So this program for Lucy Long to take her medication shows up here for 1 p.m. And then all of the programs that can be done anytime throughout the day that don't have a scheduled time are shown underneath that. Now you can also come up here and change the view so that you only see the programs for one participant. So I'll choose Lucy, hit done, and now you can see here, now I'm only seeing the programs that have been set up for Lucy Long. Furthermore, I can change the filter that is applied by changing the sort view. So for example, I can sort by status, which means has it been completed or not. I can sort by the time, the scheduled. I can sort by the patient. So if I'm viewing all of them, then I can sort by patient. And then I can also sort by the program name. So let's go, for example, back to viewing all of my patients. Hit done. So now you can see the default is by status, and I'm going to select patient. So now when I come in here, I can see all of the programs I need to do with Dolly, then Lucy, then Violet, and so on. So that just changes that view. If I change the view to time, then I'll see those that have a scheduled time and then any time. Now to show by status, let me go into one of these programs. So let's go into household chores for Dolly. I select the program and it's going to take me into a screen that shows me all of the details about that program. So for example, what service it falls under, how frequent I'm supposed to do it, what the objective is, the instructions that I need to go through to complete it, and then if there's additional information, which I know that there is because I see the more button, here's another way to have some reinforcements. So all of that information is displayed each time. Now below kind of that header, this is where you have the section where you can enter the data for that specific date. So you can see it defaults to today's date. It also defaults to the current time, but that time can also be changed, as can the date. You can see there. And then I can indicate that the program was completed. And here I'm supposed to enter in which chore was completed. So I'll enter bed. Was it completed in a single interval? Yes. I can indicate what was the level of assistance that was needed. That brings up my drop-down list here. So I'll say minimal assistance. And then if there's any comments that I need to enter, I can click those here. Now just so you know, one of the nice features about the mobile application is you can utilize the microphone or the voice recognition if your device supports it. So say for example, completed all by herself. I can speak into it and then it compiles it for me and puts the information in there. So this is really, really handy if you have some long comments that you need to put in. So now that we've saved that program, you can see that that program has been marked as completed now. So it goes to the bottom of the list because we're sorted by Dolly. If we came up here and selected status, Now I can see all the programs that have not yet been completed, and at the bottom is the completed program. So it really just comes down to what your workflow is. If you want to see all of your tasks at a time, if you need to filter the list by the individual that you're currently with, whatever that workflow is, there are lots of different ways to look at the data so that you can make it best work for you. Now, the nice thing is you can also document multiple times on one program. So let's go back into that household chores program. You can see here that one was completed at 4:25, but let's say she does another household chore. So I'll select new. The same information is displayed at the top. I can indicate completed. I'll put dishes in here this time. In a single interval, level of assistance. Let's say I really had to help her. And now I can save it. So now you can see we have two entries. And if we go back to our list, again, scrolling to the bottom because we're going by status, you can see that this number has increased to 2 because we now have 2 entries. Now, there are lots of different programs that are in here that are scheduled, not necessarily time-wise, but scheduled for today. So, for example, these programs that say daily, that's why they're showing up in the list. There are also programs that you might have that only occur once a month. So, in order to document on those programs, you select Add. And this will take you to a list of those programs. So, for example, Dolly only needs to clean the bathroom once a week, and she does that on Friday. You can see that here, weekly F. So since today is not Friday, it's a Thursday, that program is not showing up in the display for today. But let's say she decides to clean the bathroom early. Instead of doing it tomorrow, she wants to do it today. I can select the program. I can go in and enter the information. Let's say it took one environmental cue. It was a success. She did those two things. I can enter in all of this other information. And not all of it's required, so I can skip some of it and select save. And even though that program wasn't scheduled for today, now it's come off of that list, but now you can see it underneath completed, cleans bathroom, because we did complete it today. So again, even if the program is not scheduled to occur today, you can still go in and document because we know that things change in order and there's going to be variances throughout your interaction with your clients. That's pretty much everything that I have to cover as far as data entry on the mobile application. As soon as you hit the sync button, that information is going to go back up to the server and be available and accessible by the management and or by you on the web application. So as you can see, it's really nice that being able to collect that information on the mobile application really gives visibility and helps you to easily track the information that you need to track regarding your clients. If you have any additional questions, don't hesitate to visit our website or give us a call. You can find more information on www.fieldsyncmobile.com. Thank you for your time.